Good morning and a warm welcome to India Today. The breaking news that we're getting at the top of this hour, India Today is the only channel to speak to Parambir Singh in Mumbai. He is in Mumbai to join the pro. Parambir Singh has said that he has faith in the judiciary and he says that he was in Chandigarh, and India Today is the first channel to trace missing Parambir. Listen in.
हमारे साथ हैं परमबीर सिंह, पूर्व मुंबई पुलिस कमिश्नर. सर, ये बताएंगे आप इन्वेस्टिगेशन ज्वाइन करने के लिए आए हैं?
हाँ, मैं इन्वेस्टिगेशन ज्वाइन करने आया हूँ सुप्रीम कोर्ट के आदेश के हिसाब से.
सर, ये जानना चाहेंगे कि आगे की प्रक्रिया क्या होगी? सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने प्रोटेक्शन दी है, पर आगे आप फिर भी कोई अपील?
सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने उस प्रकार से मैं कोऑपरेट करूंगा.
और सर, ये जो केसेस रजिस्टर किए जा रहे हैं उस पर आपका क्या कहना है? सर,
नहीं, मुझे कुछ कहना नहीं है.
Right, you heard Parambir Singh there speak exclusively to my colleague Divesh. Sahil Joshi is joining me live from Mumbai right now, a Mumbai bureau chief. Sahil, this of course is because Parambir Singh has been granted protection from arrest by the Supreme Court. What is likely to happen right now? Is the Mumbai police going to go ahead and question him, or are they going to wait for more clarity from the Supreme Court, which has said that Parambir Singh needs to join the investigation by December 6?
Well, Paulmi, Parambir Singh, as spoken to me yesterday, has kept his word, and he has come to Mumbai. He had said yesterday that he will be joining the investigation soon, as asked by the Supreme Court, because Supreme Court's order was very clear that he should be protected from any kind of arrest. But at the same time, the court had asked Parambir Singh to join the investigation meanwhile, because on 6th of December, the court is going to hear the Maharashtra government side, their reply to Parambir Singh's petition in the Supreme Court, as well as they have asked the CBI also to file their reply, because Parambir Singh is asking the Supreme Court to transfer all these cases against him to the CBI. There are 4 cases of extortion against former Mumbai Police Commissioner Parambir Singh, 2 in Mumbai and 2 in Thane, and there are 2 open inquiries against him started by the Anti-Corruption Bureau. So all these 6 cases should be transferred to the CBI is what his petition is, but because now the Supreme Court had asked him that you should join the investigation and he has got the required protection which he has been asking for, he has argued in the court that the cases against him are kind of taking a revenge against him for writing the letter to the Chief Minister Uddhav Thackeray, on the basis of which the CBI and the ED has registered the case, and Anil Deshmukh is in the judicial custody at this point of time with ED. So looking at that, Parambir Singh had no other option than to join the investigation, but he has come as asked by the Supreme Court. He will be joining the investigation. Now we'll have to wait and see that which case he joins for, because there are 2 non-bailable warrants against Parambir Singh. In one case, he has been declared as proclaimed offender. The Mumbai police, in their affidavit to the magistrate, had said that he was not found at his official residence in Mumbai. They also went to Chandigarh to search him. They could not find him in Chandigarh as well. After that, the magistrate declared him proclaimed offender. They had registered the case, and they also went ahead and put the notice on his home that he has been declared as a proclaimed offender, because after 1 month, if still the Parambir Singh shouldn't have come to the police station or wherever the case has been registered, then they could have confiscated his properties, and it looks like now that he will be joining the investigation to get over this proclaimed offender order of the magistrate court. It's going to be really crucial for the Maharashtra police, because the Maharashtra government did not file the reply. They did not file the caveat when the case had come to the Supreme Court. So it has come on the Maharashtra government that even if they wanted to take action against Parambir Singh, they did not act in swift and they did not file the caveat. And that is the reason why he managed to get the protection from the Supreme Court, and now they have to file their reply on the 6th of December. It's a big story.
Absolutely.
For the first time in Mumbai's political life, the police commissioner is now coming to the police station where the case against him has been registered, and the former home minister is in the judicial custody based on the letter sent by the same police commissioner. It's going to be really tricky at this point of time, even Supreme Court expressed their feelings with respect to that, and they specifically mentioned that it doesn't look good on the Maharashtra police, that their own police officer says that he doesn't feel safe when the police is investigating. So that is going to be really crucial. How the thing turns further, if there is any new case registered against Paramveer Singh or the Maharashtra government decides to arrest him, it's something what we have to see. But right now, Paramveer Singh, exclusively speaking to India Today, has made it very clear that he joining the investigation as asked by the Supreme Court. It's something big we are breaking at this point of time on India Today.
Absolutely, Sahil. The big story, like you said, the big story. Paramveer Singh has landed in Mumbai in order to join the investigation. And like you said, he lodged a complaint against a former home minister. The home minister is in judicial custody. And the former police commissioner of Mumbai is now going to appear before the Mumbai police in an investigation against him. Sahil, stay on with us. Let's listen in to what Paramveer Singh said.
हमारे साथ हैं परमबीर सिंह, पूर्व मुंबई पुलिस कमिश्नर. सर, ये बताएंगे आप इन्वेस्टिगेशन ज्वाइन करने के लिए आए हैं?
हाँ, मैं इन्वेस्टिगेशन ज्वाइन करने आया हूँ सुप्रीम कोर्ट के आदेश के हिसाब से.
सर, ये जानना चाहेंगे कि आगे की प्रक्रिया क्या होगी? सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने प्रोटेक्शन दी है, पर आगे आप फिर भी कोई अपील?
सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने उस प्रकार से मैं कोऑपरेट करूंगा.
और सर, ये जो केसेस रजिस्टर किए जा रहे हैं उस पर आपका क्या कहना है? सर,
नहीं, मुझे कुछ कहना नहीं है. जो मुझे कहना है कोर्ट में कह चुका हूँ, कोर्ट में ही कहूंगा.
Right, Sahil Joshi continues to be with us live from Mumbai. Sahil, these six cases that you explained, a total of six cases, two in Mumbai, two in Thane, and then of course the two other cases of the ACB as well. How much of trouble do they spell for Paramveer Singh, especially because he's been declared a proclaimed offender in one of those instances?
Well, the cases started being registered against Paramveer Singh after that big letter was written by Paramveer Singh against Anil Deshmukh. The first case was registered at Marine Drive Police Station in Mumbai, on which the case was transferred to the CID branch, and they are investigating that particular case. The other case was registered with Mumbai's Goregaon Police Station by one Bimal Agarwal, who is a businessman, and he has claimed that along with Riaz Bhatti and Sachin Waze, Paramveer Singh tried to extort money from him. That case was transferred to the Mumbai Crime Branch, and in that case, first there was a non-bailable warrant issued against Paramveer Singh. He still failed to appear to join the investigation, and after that, finally, the magistrate declared him proclaimed offender in that case. The case is with the Mumbai Crime Branch. They will be investigating that particular case. Now it is interesting to see that once Paramveer Singh joins the investigation, whether he approaches the court again, because that route is open to him, that he had joined the investigation. The magistrate court has declared him proclaimed offender because he had not joined the investigation. If he still does not join the investigation, then that notice of being a proclaimed offender turns into seizing the properties. The Mumbai police will start seizing the properties. So again, the Paramveer Singh, after he joins the investigation, he can approach the court again, the magistrate court, and can inform them that as asked, he had joined the investigation, the confiscation of the properties, the seizure of the properties should be stopped, and he can get that order from the magistrate court. So he can be saved. It will be a big relief for Paramveer Singh, because the police had already gone to his properties and stick the notices issued by the magistrate court as a proclaimed offender. So that is going to be another fight. On 6th of December, when the Supreme Court will sit to hear the petition again, and it is expected that the Maharashtra government will be filing the reply soon. The CBI will be filing the reply soon. And on that day, Paramveer Singh's lawyers can claim that as ordered by the Supreme Court, because please understand, even during the Supreme Court hearing, Paramveer Singh's lawyers kept mentioning specifically that if the case is with the CBI, within 48 hours, Paramveer Singh is ready to join the investigation, but he does not trust the Maharashtra police because the action here is out of vengeance, and that is the reason why he doesn't want to join the investigation, is what he had told the court. Now the court had given him the protection. The court also asked him to join the investigation. So obviously he had to come to Mumbai and report to the police stations where the cases have been registered against him. That is something which he is following at this point of time. On 6th of December, before 6th of December, his lawyers can approach the magistrate and can claim that now that he had joined the investigation, he should be relieved from being a proclaimed offender. That notice should be taken back. And then on the 6th of December, he can again go to the Supreme Court and say that, as asked by the Supreme Court, he had joined the investigation. That is going to be really key and crucial at this point of time. It's going to be really interesting, the fight between the Maharashtra government and Paramveer Singh, how it is going to turn up. The first round, Paramveer Singh seems to have won, because Maharashtra government, despite there was a petition in the Supreme Court, did not file the caveat, and that is the reason why the day Supreme Court gave Paramveer Singh the protection from arrest, the Maharashtra government did not file the same. And that is the reason why he could get the protection. It's something what is being discussed in the political circles at this point of time. This is going to be really interesting what happens further. But at this point of time, it's very clear that Paramveer Singh has reached Mumbai and will directly join the investigation in the cases filed against him by the Mumbai police and Thane police.
Absolutely. Sahil, thank you so much for joining us with all of those details. We'll, of course, keep coming back to you through the day, because this is the big story that we're tracking. India Today was the first channel to tell you that missing, quote-unquote, Paramveer Singh is actually in Chandigarh. And now India Today has brought you that exclusive interview with Paramveer Singh as he landed at the Mumbai airport. Listen in again to Paramveer Singh.
हमारे साथ हैं परमबीर सिंह, पूर्व मुंबई पुलिस कमिश्नर. सर, ये बताएंगे, आप इन्वेस्टिगेशन ज्वाइन करने के लिए आए हैं?
हाँ, मैं इन्वेस्टिगेशन ज्वाइन करने आया हूँ सुप्रीम कोर्ट के आदेश के हिसाब से.
सर, ये जानना चाहेंगे कि आगे की प्रक्रिया क्या होगी. सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने प्रोटेक्शन दी है, पर आगे आप फिर भी कोई अपील
है सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने, उस प्रकार से मैं कोऑपरेट करूंगा इन्वेस्टिगेशन.
और सर, ये जो केसेस रजिस्टर किए जा रहे हैं, उस पर आपका क्या कहना है? सर,
नहीं, मुझे कुछ कहना नहीं है. जो मुझे कहना है कोर्ट में कह चुका हूँ, कोर्ट में ही कहूँगा.